ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरम् ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयं व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम् अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीं अम्बत्वामनुसन्तदामि भगवद्गीते भवद्मेषिनी यं ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्ररुद्रमरुतः स्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः वेदैः साङ्गपदक्रमोपनिषदैः गायन्ति यं सामगाः ध्यानावस्थिततद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यं योगिनो यस्यान्तं न विदुःसुरा सुरगणाः देवाय तस्मै नमः देवाय तस्मै नमः अतः पञ्चमोऽध्यायः श्रीभगवान् उवाच अर्जुन उवाच सन्न्यासं कर्मणां कृष्ण पुनर्योगं च शंससि यच्छ्रेय एतयोरेकं तन्मे ब्रूहि सुनिश्चितम् श्रीभगवानुवाच सन्न्यासकर्मयोगश्च निःश्रेयसकरावुभौ तयोस्तु कर्मसन्न्यासात् कर्मयोगो विशिष्यते ज्ञेयः स नित्यसन्न्यासी यो न द्वेष्टि न काङ्क्षति निर्द्वन्द्वो हि महाबाहो सुखं बन्धात् प्रमुच्यते साङ्ख्ययोगौ पृथक् बालाः प्रवदन्ति न पण्डिताः एकमप्यास्तितः सम्यक् उभयोर्विन्दते फलम् So the topic of this chapter is Sannyas Yoga, which does not mean all of us are here to take sannyas. Aisa nahi hai. Do not misunderstand that Bhagavan Krishna wants everybody to go, takes up sannyas and leave the world. That's not the idea. That's why he wants to clarify. This is what Arjuna was jumping into. He says that you have said both of them are great. Between these two, which is best? I want to know about that. Sanyasam karmanam krishna punar yogam cha samsasi. Yashreya etayoregam tanme bruhi sunishtitam. Please tell me which is really meant best for me. And most of us, all of us, I would say, are in the shoes of Arjuna only at the present moment. Why I am saying this is, you know, if you are hungry and the plate of food is in front of you, which is meant for you only, you ask people, should I eat? What's your opinion about it? Anybody has any opinion about to eat or not to eat? Do you ask? Why not? If you're really hungry and the food is there, you don't need to ask anybody. Do you take permission from your home, everybody, before you sleep? How about what's your opinion? Should I sleep or not? Of course, when you're doing that in the workplace, you have to do that. You take permission from your boss. I am sleeping for a while, please. So, the very fact that Arjuna asked this question, should I or not? That means what? He himself is doubtful. And to the top of that, Krishna says, one time he says, best is to renounce, to reach the highest truth. Another moment he says, just do action. So he gets confused. Echreya etayo rayam tanme bruhi sunischit. Tell me for precisely what it is. And as usual, Bhagavan Krishna says, actually both are good. Sanyasa karma yogasya nishreyasa karau ubau. Both of them are going to give you the best. But tayoho tu, in between these two, karma sanyasa, then renunciation of action, karma yoga vishishyati. Karma yoga excels. And within bracket you have to clearly put for you. For whom? For Arjuna and everybody in this world who is having the hesitation to give up. Because the very hesitation means what? You have some attachment somewhere. So among these two, but first, and then in the third verse he said, now please remember one thing. Renunciation is not just giving up things. Renunciation is where you don't exist. Meaning, we are nothing but the bundle of likes and dislikes. Strong prejudices. I want this, I like this, I die for this, I hate this, I don't like this, I want to run away from this. So this kind of polarities that we have in our life, he who does not have that is a sannyasi. Nyasya nitya sannyasi yo na dveshti. He doesn't hate. Na kaankshati. He doesn't desire anything. Nirdvando hi mahabhava. He has gone beyond these dualities. Sukham bandhat pramuchyate. Such a person alone easily can come out of bondage. What is bondage then? These two, which are pulling you in both directions, that is the bondage. So bondage is not, as we have seen before also, it's not the world is binding you in any way. Is the world holding you in captivity, tying you down to a pole? It is not. Our own mind. Which is our own actually. It's very interesting. Our own mind is able to hold us captive. Interesting. One person was dreaming. And my favorite dream is, lion was chasing him. So he ran. You know, just so exhausted. After he ran for a while, and suddenly he took some courage and turned around. Look at that lion. What are you going to do to me? He asked the lion. The lion said, it's your dream, you decide. So, in a dream, that lion is also part of your own mind only. But not knowing that it is that which is threatening me is also my own mind only. Not knowing that is suffering. Bondage. So what is bondage then? Not knowing that all that I am thinking of, that which is causing me fear, jealousy, hatred, anger, frustration or attraction and all the... My own mind. tussling in the dream, that tiger cannot do anything which you don't like it to do. In the same way, it is our own mind which has created this hell for us. Kama krodhascha lopasya tasmat edatrayam tejet. Bhagavan Krishna very clearly says, trividam naragasya idam dvaram nashanam atmanah. Only three things that can destroy you and take you to hell. Kama, krodh or lobh. Passion or lust, anger and greed. So, he is considered as a sannyasin. Nyeyasya nitya sannyasi yo nadveshti nakangshati. He has gone beyond the pairs of opposites which are causing this trouble. Nirdvandvohi mahabaho, o mighty armed Arjuna, sukam bandhat pramuchyate. Such a person comes out of the bondage very well. Now, Arjuna thinks that he just went outside the topic. Why? I asked you whether it is renunciation of action is good or giving up, or engaging in action is good. You said that giving up action, compared to that, giving up the result of action is better. Now, why are you coming back to sannyas? No, I am telling you. This state of renunciation in your mind does not happen unless you have taken the first step. I want to go to, let us say, some other part of the country, but I don't even start the car, then what will happen? I am in the world of karma, action. What should be my step immediately? Do the action to start with, without seeking or being anxious about the result. That's the first step. Without taking the first step. Now, why do you need to seek a result? Because I like it. I like to have this and I don't want this. So, likes and dislikes are already there. And how can you take up sannyas then? So, that's why he says, people who do not understand, they are complementary, not competitive. They are one step leading to another step, which you do not understand. You think they are contradictory. So therefore he says, Sankhya Yoga Prithak. These two are different. Iti balaha pravadanti. Only in innocent, uneducated, illiterate or thoughtless people say. Na panditaha. Men of wisdom don't talk like that, because they know the step. If you are ready for the highest renunciation, you don't even ask that question. Since you are not even sure about that last step or renunciation, obviously you are in the beginning stage. And beginning stage you have to prepare. That is why in 6th chapter also Krishna makes it clear. Aru rukshor muner yoham karma karanam uchyate yoga arudasya tasyeva shamak karanam uchyate. We will see that after 5th, 6th will come. Let us say that you are trying to ride on a horse. What you should do first? You want to ride on a horse. What do you do? First of all, you must be having a horse. And the horse must be available to you first. And then when you try to get onto the horse, you know what it will do? What it will do? It will kick you out. Because he doesn't want anybody else to get on. Unless that, trainer is next to him. So the trainer is, shh, quiet. This one comes down now. Quiet. Then it will stand because he said so. Then you try to get on to the horse. Once you get on to the horse and the trainer leaves his hand, finished. That fellow will run in such a way that you will have to fall. Why? Because he doesn't want you. Nobody to come in. Nobody wants somebody else to control. So the horse also doesn't want. In the same way, a person who is trying to meditate, what is most important to him is availability of the mind. The mind itself is not available. What is it you are going to meditate? Meaning, not only mind is available, mind is under your command. You want to think about what you want to think and stop thinking. If that mind itself is not available, then what are you going to do in the seat of meditation? So Krishna says, in the seat of meditation, you don't try to control the mind. In the seat of meditation, you already control the mind. Then only it is, you can proceed further. To control the mind means what? It is not going here and there. To not going here and there means what? It is not preoccupied. Not preoccupied means what? It is not anxious about what is going to happen. Not anxious means what? You have given up likes and dislikes. That's what is Karma Yoga is about. So, Karma Yoga or practice of Karma Yoga is that which is a preparation for giving up your idea that I am the doer. First is Bhoktrutva Tyaga, renunciation of Phalam, result. Then Kartrutva Tyaga, renunciation of the idea that I am the doer. Then comes Karma Tyaga, giving up the action. You cannot just give up the action while the desires are very intense in your mind. A plate of rasagulla in front of you. I want to eat, but what will others say? I want to eat, but what will others say? So if you have a desire to eat, and because others are looking at you are not eating, what will you do later? Nobody is there. Eat. Because the action is temporarily is suspended. You are not renounced. You are only temporarily controlling your desire of action. But desire is still there. And once the occasion arises when nobody is there, jump into it. So, therefore, renunciation of action is not an external physical activity. It is something to be done here. In 18th chapter also, Bhagavan Krishna says, Chetasa sarva karmani sanyasya mai sanyasya matparaha. Chetasa sarva karmani mai sanyasya. Keep this on renouncing all action in the mind, in me. Then mat prasada davapnodi shashvatam padam avyayam. Then only he will achieve the highest. So now here, Sankhya means samyakyayate, very well spoken, meaning knowledge, the path of knowledge. Yoga here means path of action. So path of knowledge and path of action are not contradictory to each other. One may think like path of knowledge means renounce action. No. Path of knowledge means knowing how to engage in that action. While action continues, your attitude changes. That is why Bhagavan very clearly says that unless you have gained that correct understanding, don't give up physical action. And physical action you continue to do, renouncing the anxiety for the result, mind gets prepared, and in that prepared mind, knowledge takes place, and with the knowledge you can move further. On the last session also I told you that you take soap, I remember, you take the soap and apply it on your body, right, while taking shower. Then after that you put on the water, and what do you do? Both the soap and the dirt, both are gone. So why do you put the soap? So that the dirt will be removed. Even though the soap is an external thing, which is not part of your body, but that serves the purpose of cleaning your dirt away from the body, and then both the soap and the dirt have to go away. In the same way, Karma Yoga is an activity you perform in such a way that your mind is devoid of all impurities, and then even that mind which is engaged in action and all those, that also to be renounced. We have been doing so many different things in the daily life. At the end of every day, what happens to you? Sab ko chhod diya. I am in the state of blissful sleep. I want nothing. Is it not true that at the end of the day you renounce the whole thing? In that renounce, kasya sukam na karodi virag. What joy that vairagya that happens every day and night cannot give you. Is it not that you give up everything and then it's a she gave up, see like that. She gave up even this lecture itself, she gave up. Swami, I give up the lecture also. Now, therefore, one should understand, there are two things that needs to be given up. One, to start with, I want to enjoy the result of this action. I am the enjoyer of the result of action. That idea should be given up. Bhoktru, it's called bhoga. Then comes idea that I am the doer. That also you should give up. But to just having a result in mind and not to have, not to give up, I am the doer, is not easy. Like Ramana Maharshi will ask, you know, I have a desire to eat something, let us say. You have a desire to eat something? Yes. So you cannot say, don't eat it. It's difficult for us to just give up. All right. Who wants to eat? I. Who is this I? I is a tongue, I is a hand, I is the mind, I is a thought, I is the ego. Who is this I? Who wants to give up? So when you start inquiring into that, you will find that it's all illusion that is going here. Is the tongue wants the food or what? You tell me. Is the tongue is interested in that rasagulla? Or the hand? Which is interested in eating the rasagulla? You tell me. Hand? Or the plate? Plate is interested in eating rasagulla. No. Hand? Hand is not interested in rasagulla. Tongue? Is it tongue? Say something, you know. Is it tongue? With, no, answer only once. Is the tongue or not? Objective answer, yes, no. And then third one is, I don't know. Which one is that? Tongue, yes, no, I don't know. Which one? No, so B. Not tongue. Next. Is it the mind? Yes, no, don't know. Huh? Now I am going to ask a fourth question, then you will change the answer. Four. Is it desire? Yes. So the mind is not the mind. A thought in the mind. A desire, a tendency, a vasana. That's what it is, vasana. The vasana, the taste, the impressions. Which is now in the form of, I want it. Mind is only a tool there. Vasana is what is prompting us. Now, your vasana or tendency or impressions, past impressions, all those things, that is the one, is that the one who is seeking this rasagulla? Yes, no, I don't know. Everybody is quiet. What is the next one coming? Which one?
Yes.
Yes, vasanas. So, for last question is, am I my vasanas? Am I the bundle of impressions or the one who knows this bundle of impressions? Am I? Yes, no, I don't know. Now presently say, I don't know, doesn't matter. So the vasanas that are there in our inherently there present because of the past actions and various other things that we have gone through accumulated, that is prompting the thoughts, and thoughts are prompting the mind is prompting the sense organs prompting the hand to go and pick it up. So many things are happening here. So when you travel back and you'll find, I am not this bundle of impressions and thoughts. Once you realize that, who actually wants this now? Me, you? Is that what you want? No, my vasanas want. Good. You have a choice? When I think that I am the vasana, I have no choice. Because vasanas demand, which means I demand, and therefore I want it. But if I see myself not the vasana, then I have a choice. Okay, why do I need to do encourage this? I don't need to. But this cannot happen if the mind is not pure. mind is not alert. That is why Krishna says, it is not easy for a person to come to this stage of analysis and abiding in higher nature, because by momentum of habit, we have been associated ourselves with the vasanas and thoughts and emotions and feelings, and accordingly we just go on doing things, and therefore you don't even ask this question. To ask this question, you should slow down, look in and understand. That is called Sankhya Yoga. Understand? Sankhya means Buddhi Yoga. Knowledge, path of analysis. But this cannot happen if the mind is preoccupied with anger, lust, passion, greed, jealousy, and we live so mechanically everything. Do we? Everything mechanically. We don't even ask, why am I doing this? In Ashtavakra Gita, beautifully there is a verse which says, just like when you are, let us say that you go outside this hall, not now, afterwards, when you go. And so many people are doing so many things. Somebody is in this desk, is calling some people, and somebody is walking around, somebody is cleaning something, and all those things. When you see many people doing many things, you see a body in action. Many bodies in action, doing this, doing that. You are only witnessing, you are just watching. I don't recommend that, but anyway, just sit there, stand and watch. So many people are doing so many things. The same attitude of you watching bodies acting, if you do the same thing with your own self, your own body, there is a big transformation that will take place. It'll come later on, he's going to say that. You start looking at you different from the body. This body is now sitting here. This body is now talking. This body is now hearing. I am watching it. Just like I watch any other body outside doing things. If I start looking at my own self as independent of myself, and you will find all blunders, all mistakes, all unnecessary word, all unnecessary reactions into this world, all this will change. And you'll be careful before you say anything. Before you do anything, you'll be aware. Stop. This is not right. Presently, we are not able to do that because we are in a flow. Yesterday I did that, today I will do it, tomorrow also I will do the same thing. Why? I never even asked that question. So, Sankhya Yoga is where an individual renounces that Kartrutva, I am the doer idea. But that is not possible without you taking the previous step of, I am not deriving any pleasure out of this. Bhoktrutva should go away. I am the bhokta, I am the enjoyer of this particular action or whatever I say, whatever I do. Therefore, here in the next verse, verse number 5, Yet Sankhe Prapyate Sthanam Tat Yogairapi Gamyate Ekam Sankhyam Cha Yogam Cha Yav Pashyati Sapashyati Yet Sankhe Prapyate Sthanam Tat Yogairapi Gamyate Ekam Sankhyam Cha Yogam Cha Yap Pashyati Sapashyati Yet Sthanam, that which state Sankhyaihi Prapyate, by the Sankhyans. There is a grammar work here, but anyway. Sankhya here means not only the path of knowledge, but those who are walking the path of knowledge also. Sankhyaihi Janaihi Prapyate, Sthanam Prapyate. Tat Yogaihi means Yoginai, Yogin, the Shabda, to be understood. Yoga here means those who are walking the path of yoga. Yogaihi abhigamyate is reached. What sthanam is that? Is it Afghanistanam, Hindustanam or Pakistanam? Baluchistanam? Stha is to stay. Sthana is a station. In Sanskrit, the sthanam, but English became station. Abode, a place, a state, a being. So, that sthanam, what state is that? 51st state of United States. The 50 states are there. 51st state is called Brahmasthanam. A state where there is no question of you coming out of it anymore. A state of being where there is no more end. It's eternal state. So, yat sthanam, avyayasthanam, sankhyaihi prapyate, by the men of knowledge it is obtained, tad, that very thing, yogaihi api, by yoga also, prapyate, argamyate, is reached. It's sankhyai prapyate sthanam, tad yogair abhigamyate. Then what is the difference? Why two paths at all? If two roads can lead to the same place, what are these two roads are? It means it starts somewhere else. So, where an individual is still having lot of vasanas and impurities, he has to engage in the path of action to become pure, and such a pure mind alone can inquire and get into that state of abidance in the highest. While a person who has already become purified by past karmas or past practices, for such a person it is easy to switch. But it is the same point. It is similar to your Indian parents. AP class. What is this? Regular class is shown. What is it? AP. Advanced practices, right? What is that? Advanced placement. Placement, you see the placement. Advanced placement. Swamiji, you know, I asked, so your son is studying in 8th grade? Yes. But actually, AP is 9. What? No, 8th grade is studying, but he is actually going to classes that will 9th and 10th. Why? No, but he is very smart, Swamiji. Oh. We are not at all content. But everybody does, and everybody is foolish, and you also can continue that. No, Swamiji is such, only then only we will get in big universities. And then do what? You're going to rot in the same way after marriage. You cannot tell your wife, you don't shout at me, I did AP. Advanced blaming everybody. Whether you AP or MP or UP, whatever it is, we are just not satisfied. When we were studying, when we are in 10th grade, we are only in the 10th grade, nothing else. 11th grade, 11th grade. 12th, 12th grade. First year of college, nothing else. Why under attention? Summer school, about what? 3rd grade. Third year, now it's. Then what are you going to do in 3rd year? 4th year. What are you going to do 4th year? What are you going to do in 4th year? Postgraduate. I don't know. Anyway, it doesn't matter. So what it means is, so a person who has already had, due to previous life and their practices earlier, those who already purified their mind are capable of renouncing that fruit of action easily, and they are in the process of renouncing their actorship. I am the doer. That idea that I am the doer is, they are in the process of renouncing that. So they don't need to do karma palatyaga, or they don't need to go through the karma yoga. But finally what they reach is the same place the other person who has just started doing that, and ultimately you will reach there only. Yat sthanam sankhyaihi prapyate tat yogaihi abhigamyate. Ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha. Therefore, ekam phalam sankhyam cha yogam cha. This is only one final result. Yappashyati sapashyati. He who sees this, such a person sees this. In other words, in spirituality, don't imitate others. Don't imitate somebody else. Oh, she did it. Oh, he did it. You evaluate yourself. Where are you? There's no competition here. Oh, she put extra flower. I also would put. Durga only smiles. What's the problem here? You, each one of you, have to walk your path. Don't imitate others. Swadharma bibi. Swadharma karma. This, whatever is your swadharma. Swadharma nidhanam shreya. Paradharma bayava. Don't do somebody else's work. What is given to you, what is your path, you take that. Don't say, oh, another. No end to this. But we are what to do? Monkeys imitating, it's our nature. What does monkeys do? Whatever you do, they keep on imitating. That's our nature, what to do. So in this, I need to evaluate, is my mind full of anger, lust, passion, greed, jealousy? Then I must do the work, offering my actions and results to the Lord and keep doing my best. Rest He will take care. Bhagavan Krishna says, therefore, machitta sadadam karma, sarva karmanya apisada kurvano mat vyapashrayaha. He, the one who is doing all the actions, keeping me as a support, not anybody else. In your action, there should not be any other support other than the Lord. What do you mean by that? You see, this world is running in its own axis, revolving in its own axis, and this earth is also going around the sun. Who is doing that? Anyone take responsibility? Because without that, there can be a day or night. There can be change of seasons. The flower that is growing behind in your garden, who claims to be doing this? The air that you are drinking, the air that is flowing, who claims to be doing this? Bisha asmat vatapavade bisha dudedi surya bisha indrascha agnischa mrityurdhavadi panchamayidi. Upanishad says very clearly, due to the fear of that Lord alone, sun is rising, fire is burning, air is flowing, water is flowing. So when we do action, please don't take support of anything else other than the Lord. Sarva karmanyapi sada kurvano matvyapashraya matprasadadavapnodi shashvatam padam avyayam. That is what is called shashvatam padam. Here refers to sthanam. That avyayam sthanam, that imperishable abode, I give it. Matprasadadavapnodi. By my grace you get it. Bhagavan says, do your work. So, therefore, idea is that if I am anxious about the result of action, first of all, if I am anxious about the result of action, my action is compromised. Because half of the mind is anxious about that. Let us say a person is singing from the stage. While singing, the mind is everybody appreciating or not? All are smiling or not? How much clap I would get? And who is enjoying more? First row, second row, third row, I saw most of them sleeping. See, if your mind is just engaged in anxious about what's going to happen, then you are not singing. Your singing will be sacrificed. When your mind is preoccupied with anxiety for the result, action is compromised. So, when you give up that idea of enjoyership, result it will come, whatever has to come. Let me do my best. With that focus in my mind, Let the Lord take care. Whoever is the one who is finally going to give the result, let it happen. Let me do the best. That is a preparation. Once the mind is thus prepared, when the mind is not anxious about any of these things, it also gives up likes and dislikes. Whatever comes to me is a prasad. Then where is the question of, I like it, I don't like it? Mat prasada dabapnoti, my grace will flow through you, where you will reach the highest state. So here, whether you are walking the path of knowledge, which is already your mind has prepared enough, there is no impurities, thereby you are able to take that course of self-inquiry to find yourself as the self and not that vasana bundles and thoughts and emotions and feelings and all other things. That inquiry can take place only if the mind is calm, quiet, peaceful, available. That is the path of Sankhya. But preparation for that is karma, or here referred as yoga. See, in yoga, bhoktrutva tyagaha, and in Sankhya, kartrutva tyaga. Final result is where neither you are an enjoyer nor you are a doer, you are me. The Lord says, you are me. No, don't worry about that. So I am acting through you. Yatsankhe prapyate sthanam, that abode reached by the men of knowledge, tat yogairapi gamyate, that even the men of action will reach. Ekam sankhyam cha yogam cha, therefore, both are really speaking, leading to the same point. Yap pashyati sa pashyati, he who sees clearly, he sees this. That's why if you say they are two different things, bhalaha pravadanti, men of no wisdom alone say that one is better than the other, but not panditaha, men of knowledge won't say that. So if somebody says, okay, now let me see, if in case I jump into that state of sannyas without doing any karma yoga, what will happen to me? I'll learn on the way. Many people are like that. Do you know driving? No, I learn on the way. You mean to say you learn on the way? On the way there will be nobody afterwards if you are learning on the way. Everyone will be destroyed by you on the way. So don't take to a path without a preparation. Some people are very bold. So what? I will do it. Then you will find yourself in great, great trouble. So therefore, in the next verse he says, Sanyasastu Mahabaho Dukkamaptum Ayogataha Yoga Yukto Munir Brahma Nachirena Dhigachati Sanyasastu Mahabaho Dukkamaptum Ayogataha Yoga Yukto Munir Brahma Nachirena Dhigachati. A person without preparation jumps into this path of knowledge, which means renunciation of action. Actorship and action, he just renounces. See, renunciation of action without the renunciation of actorhood and enjoyerhood, what will happen to you? Dukkham. Sorrow only. You will start suffering that. Why? Because Bhanuvaya, right, Gerwa, whatever dress you have. Om Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya. How many people are prostrating to me? Om Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya. So I am hungry. Om Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya. People are bringing breakfast for me. Om Namah Shivaya, Namah Shivaya. You know, you are... Enjoyership is, it's still intact because you have not done anything to it. But you know, you jump into the state of renunciation without preparation means what you suffer is dukkham. That's why he says, sannyasastu mahabahu ayogatah. One who has not gone through the purification process. Just like some people don't take bath every day, you know. They don't shower every day. But they put nice clothes. And when they come, not only they are in dukkham, others are also in dukkham. When you go near there, they may look very attractive, very nice. When you go near, and especially when they open the mouth. Some people do have no concept of washing their mouth. And you know, they drink what called wine or this coffee and everything. Open the mouth, everything is yellow there. And they have the tendency to come near and talk. How are you, Swamiji? It's so difficult for me to talk to such people. You know, it so happened, and I was flying out somewhere, and I think Air France to India. France, you know, you probably you know it. So, sitting there, the flight was going to Bombay. So, and this person next to me, and he came, where this flight is going? Mumbai. I suffered through that next to 10 hours. So, you may have a nice dress and other things, but dirt is full of that. Similarly, externally renouncing, but mentally, all the impurities are there. Not only you suffer, because you cannot, you know, demonstrate, you cannot express all your desires, because you will be judged based upon that. And not only that, then you restricting yourself, controlling yourself for the sake of the world, and when nobody is there, it starts. Therefore, Krishna cautions him, saying that, E Mahabahu, O mighty armed Arjuna, sannyasaha dukkham aptum ayogatah. If you are not prepared, renunciation will be a great pain. Jatilo mundi lunjita kesaha kasha yambara bahukruta vesaha yudaranimittam. Yudaranimittam, just to fill the belly. Jatilo mundi lunjita kesaha. Pashyanna bichana pashyati moodha. They can see, but they don't see it. Earlier verse you see, yapashyati sapashyati, right? One who sees, he sees. He, even though eyes are there, he doesn't see it. Pashyanna bichana pashyati moodha. Yudaranimittam bahukruta vesaha. For the sake of building the belly, easiest profession is sadhu. Especially in Hindu culture, you know, moment you wear a dress like this, even whether you like it or not, look behind, there will be 25 of them following you. It will become a very good business, unfortunately. So, yoga yukta, but on the other hand, a person who has purified the mind, yoga yukta, one who has purified the mind, munihi, a person of contemplation, brahma adhigacchati, he reaches the abode of the Supreme Self, na chirena, not very long, quickly. Chira means long. Na chirena, within no time, he will become fit for the enlightenment. So a person who has thus purified the mind by performing the actions without anxiety for the result, because he knows it is the Lord who is finally giving the result of all my action, it is not decided by me or by my action. Such an individual slowly raises his attention that even the actor here is he only. I am not. When it comes to that kind of maturity, he engages in action with absolute freedom. Such an individual who acts in this world with so much of freedom in being what who he is. Meaning, he has become like an empty reed. Gurudev would say, the flute is empty, the Lord will play the song. If you have your own song, the Lord will just keep it yourself. I don't need it. You sing. You become empty and he will start playing that. Such an individual, he will reach the abode of the Lord within no time. Na chirena adigacchati. He will reach it within no time there. So therefore, Bhagavan Krishna here urges Arjuna to not jump to conclusions. One parachute trainer, you know, he told his students or trainees. The trainer said, first and foremost instruction about parachuting, parachute jumping. What? Don't jump to conclusions. You be careful about, before you jump, you should know exactly where you are jumping and what is the wind speed and exact calculate and then jump. Don't jump to conclusions. Similarly, he says to Arjuna, don't just jump. Engage in your action and when you are ready, you will get into that state. You don't need to worry about that. The mind and the body, everything is prepared and then you will reach there. You don't know, nobody needs to push you there. You will. Yoga yukto vishuddhatma vijitatma jitendriyah sarva bhutatma bhutatma kurvanna pina lipyate yoga yukto vishuddhatma vijitatma jitendriyah sarva bhutatma bhutatma kurvanna pina lipyate. See, beauty of Gita is when he introduces an idea, he himself will explain it. The word yoga yukta came in the previous verse, right? He, one who is enjoined with this yoga, one who is practicing yoga, he will reach the highest godhood by himself quickly. What do you mean by being yoga yukta? Now he says that. Vishuddha Atma. Yoga Yukta hai Vishuddha Atma. Meaning, a person of absolute purity. Now, when we say purity, you know, we say, let us say, a plate is there and it has a lot of dirt, etc. You say, hey, clean it up. And it is cleaned and polished and all. It's clean. We can understand an object or a material thing when it is pure, we can understand that. But how do you purify this mind? What are the parameters or indications of the mind becoming pure? First, no reaction. Reaction means what? That means the world will edrichala pasantushtaha dvandhadito vimatsaraha. The world will provide various circumstances and situations which you may not even expect. Edrichalaba, meaning whatever is happening in one's life, even when it is not of your expectation, there is no reaction to it. Only action. All our anger, lust, greed, jealousy, passion, they are all reactions. Why should it happen? Why should it happen to me? Either it is lust, or passion, or anger and frustration and jealousy, all these are all reactions. That shows intense impurity. Long way to go. Nobody needs to say, you yourself realize, oh. Don't get frustrated. Everybody started off that out there only. Nobody has suddenly just descended from the heaven pure. No. Reaction. Second, even when the reaction is there, how long is the reaction? Anger. Days together. Anger and then body getting heated up and ears are becoming red and eyes are becoming red and getting agitated. Some people live like that for years. Not one or two days. Whenever I see that reaction never ends. That means what? Much more advanced impurity that person has reached. He's getting postgraduate in impurities. So first is reaction, and the reaction continued to be for many, many years or days and months and weeks. That's a PhD in reaction, impurity. Third is inability to calm the mind at will. My mind going running all over the place. Whose mind? Whose mind? My mind. And then? I myself are uncontrollably victim of my own thoughts. At will, I cannot quieten the mind. If at all I have to quieten the mind, I have to become spiritual. See, even for Diwali, Navaratri, people becoming spiritual nowadays. Yeah, Diwali hai na, the PO. But any reason and every reason the people going behind the tail of a cock. Anyway, cocktail, right? I mean. So, mind, cannot quieten the mind. Inability to quieten the mind. And if at all one is by some chance quieten the mind, sleep. That shows in another impurity. The mind incapable of quietening. But even if you try to quieten it, next morning, gone. So, you know, nobody needs to tell you, then you will realize what kind of a personality I am. Impurities. And Swami, you know, everybody is like that. Why should I be different? That's the usual question. Everybody reacts to the situation. Why should I be different? A person who asks this question is not fit. Why? Because it is not meant for every janata, for everybody. You choose this path. And if you choose, you have to be different. No other way. Neha nanasti. There is nothing more. Or so many things are not there. Only one path. It's you, you decide. So the impurities, that's why he says, yoga yukto vishuddhatma vijita atma. Vijita means conquered. Atmanam jitaha vijitaha. Vijita atma. Visheshena jitaha. He who has exclusively conquered oneself. What? Jita indriyaha. Sense organs are under his control. So yoga yukto vishuddhatma vijitatma jitendriya. And the ultimate aim of Vedanta is to realize that your own self is the self of everyone. Your own being is the one which is in everyone. Sarva bhutatma bhutatma. It's a wonderful way of putting it. Sarva bhuta of all living beings, Atma, the self of all living beings, Bhuta Atma, my own self. My own self has become the self of all beings. Meaning, he sees oneself in everyone. Such a person, even when he engages in the world, Kurvanapi, even when he is busy in this world, Nalipyati, is unaffected by it. So ultimately, Krishna says, such a person does not seclude himself in some remote corner of the Himalayas. No. Such a person who has thus seen himself in all will engage in this world as though, like anybody else, but he is seeing the oneness, and such an individual continue to act for the benefit of all, unaffected by the result of the action. And such is a blessing of such people who are living amidst us. If at all we come across, it's a great inspiration we had of Gurudev, of such masters. You see them in vigorous activity, but always enjoying the bliss of oneself, unaffected by the result of what happens around him. Om sarve bhavantu sukhinah, sarve santu niramayah, sarve bhadrani pasyantu, ma kaschid dukkha bhag bhavet. Om shanti shanti shanti. Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namah. Hari Om.